Hi everybody, this is the Digital Marketing League and we just opened the webinar for our 2 p.m. presentation from eHorses, so bear with us for a few more minutes.
So, yeah.
Hi Sarah, hi Michelle, welcome.
Thank you for having us.
no worries. We'll wait 5 more minutes before we start.
Okay.
It's always an adventure to put the technology up. I'm glad you're here now.
Yeah, definitely. We are
there. Excellent. So welcome everybody who's just joined. This is the 2 p.m. Digital Marketing League session with eHorses, with Sarah and Michelle, both of whom you can see already on the screen. And we're going to hear how you can become popular with horses. It's one of my favorite presentations today. I'm very keen to see. So for everybody who's just joined, we're waiting a few more minutes until about 2 p.m. before we start with the Digital Marketing League presentation from eHorses. So I just heard we have a few people still in the other room that we used the hour before with iProspect, so we're trying to get them over into this one. So let's wait a few more minutes. All newcomers, welcome. This is the Digital Marketing League 2 p.m. session with eHorses. Okay, we still have people come in. That's great. Welcome to the eHorses presentation and the Digital Marketing League event. As you can see, Sarah and Michelle are already there, and we'll get started in just a few minutes. So everybody who joined new, if you wait for the eHorses presentation, you're exactly right in the spot. Don't walk away. We'll get started in just a few minutes. All right, let's get started. Welcome, everybody. Re-welcome for those who've been in previous sessions. Welcome to the next session of the Digital Marketing League. And just to put the calendar into perspective, we're at 2 p.m. right now and looking forward to seeing Sarah and Michelle, who I'll introduce in a second. After that, we'll have the Trustpilot presentation. And at 4 p.m., there is a presentation in French, actually, for all of those who want to practice their French. That's the chance to do so with Olivier Andrieux. And then at 5 p.m., we'll have John Mueller from Google answering all of your questions. But before we get there, I'm very happy to have Sarah join us. Sarah is SEO manager at eHorses and working closely also with TextBroker, which we're very happy about. And so is Michelle. She's the content manager over at eHorses. And I very much look forward to your presentation about how to get popular with horses. So ladies, over to you.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so hello everybody and welcome to our presentation about international SEO. We will tell you something about our case study in our company eHorses, and it's about how to become popular with horses all over the world. So there you can see our short agenda. We will start with an introduction about ourselves and about eHorses so that you get to know the company and you know what it is about. Then we will tell you the first steps of how we are getting more international with a special look at our SEO activities. There we will tell you what we are doing, we'll show you some examples, and we'll show you the success we have so far. And in the end, we will talk about our next steps. So first of all, my name is Michelle Holtmeier. I'm working as a content manager at eHorses. I was part of the company from 2012 to 2013 as a student. After that, I finished my master's degree. And since 2019, after working in Bangkok and Berlin, I'm back in this great team.
Good day, everyone, and thank you, TextBroker, for having us today. My name is Sarah Weyer, and I'm part of eHorses since 2019. Before that, I used to work in an agency, and I used to work as in-house SEO for a short time in Sweden as well. My first contact points with eHorses I've had back in 2016, so I'm part of the team for a while as well.
Okay, and then one of the most important parts about eHorses. eHorses was founded in 1999, and so far it is translated in 5 different languages, and we are Europe's number one online horse platform. Our business model is a typical classified model, so we have a lot of horse ads at our website, so they are creating a really high reach of it. So whenever you want to buy or to sell a horse, eHorses is hopefully the ideal platform for you, because our goal is it to connect people and horses all over the world. So we have over 60 million page impressions per month and 2.7 million visits per month. And one big point is our high organic reach. But we are also quite strong in social media. So we have a lot of Instagram followers and a lot of Facebook fans. So there we can also reach the people really, really good who are interested in buying horses or selling horses or getting more information about horse topics. Here you can see the development of the advertisements in the last years. So it's getting higher and higher. In 2017, we had about 57,000 advertisements, and in 2019, we have about 70,000 advertisements. And for this year, for 2020, we are expecting a lot more because we are getting more international, and hopefully, we are getting more ads from other countries. So every a third horse. It has a selling price of over 10,000 euro. So we have a lot of high class premium horses, which is really, really great. And every 20 minute a horse is sold via e-horses. So hopefully at the beginning of this presentation and at the end of the presentation, we have sold one horse. So here you can see the development of the users we are expecting. In 2018, we had over 500,000 unique visitors at e-horses. And for 2020, with getting more international, we are expecting almost 1.4 million of users. So hopefully we will reach this goal, but we are on a really good way so far. And here we have also an overview about the top 10 of requests from abroad. So far, almost 60% of our users are from Germany, so a national brand. But we have also a lot of international users and visitors. For example, from the United States, the Netherlands, Austria, Poland, Spain, France, and some other countries. So we are getting more international right now, and that's why we said us, okay, it's a really, really good project to get more international, because there's potential there. There are a lot of people from abroad who are interested in buying and selling horses. So we want to get bigger right now. So this is why Sarah will tell you now something about of how we produced our first steps about it.
Yes, thank you very much. So as I've just said, my first contact points with e-horses were back in 2016. And since then, a lot has changed, actually. And I'm going to tell you why we chose to focus on SEO and especially content. So here are some statistics about our German website. 40.3% of our German website traffic is already organic. So the organic search is very, very important to us. We no longer buy traffic for our German website, actually. So it's very sustainable. And that's also our long-term goal, to increase the share of organic traffic abroad to gain sustainable traffic. What you can also see on the chart is that direct traffic is very important too. So many users in Germany actually search for our brand, for e-horses, and they want to go to us and no one else. And of course, that is the goal for the other countries as well. Here are some international traffic counts. So in Germany, we are already very, very successful with our horse market, but we want to grow. Of course, we want to grow. And what you can see here is our international traffic counts. So for example, there are already a lot of users from Austria, Netherlands, Spain are visiting our website month to month. And that is also why we already have some websites especially for Austria, or especially for Spain and Poland. Also, United States and United Kingdom are able to go for an English version of our website, so we can offer our product range to these countries as well. Our standing, as I've said, in 2016, we've started with a UK and US version of eHorses, eHorses.com, and also a Netherlands version, eHorses.nl. Last year, we've published France, Spain, and Polish version of eHorses, and these websites are already performing outstandingly good, actually. We didn't expect this good numbers, but we will come to this after that. So, of course, screening our current visitors on eHorses.de is a very important step for us to choose which country we will go next for our market research and for growing. But there's a little bit more to our analysis criteria of the country selection. So after the first step, after screening which visitors are coming from, actually, our second step is to look at the number of horses. Germany and the Netherlands are very horse fanatic countries, I would say, but there are a lot of other countries which are very interested in horses but don't have the possibility yet. So the second step and the third step are very close to each other. So of course, we also look to our competitors. Are there any other horse markets? Are there any other competitors in the same section like us? And coming with that, and of course for me as an in-house SEO, it's the most important one, we are also watching the Google visibility, and we are looking if there are, is there really some interest to these countries for horses and buying horses, selling horses, horse products. And that's how we choose the markets we are expanding to. So our market development strategy, a little bit in a short version, of course. The horses from Germany are in great demand internationally, actually. We are a very horse-producing country, if you can say so. So there are a lot of excellent and high-class horse breeds from Germany, which are popular all over the world. And a lot of other countries, and especially the US, don't offer these breeds. So our goal is to get to those countries and deliver them with our wide product range, because the most countries have only small national horse markets, but no international marketplace. And that's our chance, that's where we are coming from. So our market development strategy is duplication, to duplicate our concept to the countries, but get to know through the user experience of these countries as well. A big part of that is to get in touch with our country partners. For example, for Spain and Portugal, we work with our colleague Antonio, or for Poland with Lukasz. And also Textbroker developed as a very, very partner for us as well, because of course we don't speak all of these languages, and that's a very good help for this goal.
Okay, then I will go on with our SEO activities. And first of all, I have a special look to content management, which is a really big part of the SEO activities, of course. So first of all, we thought about, okay, what can be our first steps? And for that, we had a greater look at our German website, and we had a look, okay, which landing pages have a really good organic performance. And we analyzed everything and make the conclusion that especially the horse breeds, as Sarah just told you, and the disciplines are having like a really high organic range. So we decided to have a translation of these different topics. And in the future, we also want to deal with country typical topics. Then we decided to have a mix out of a transactional and informative content, because transactional on the one hand, because you know, like when you put something in Google and you, or Bing, you are searching for a special horse breed, for example, the Heflinger, for sale or to buy or something like this as a keyword. And when we put the transactional content on a landing page, we hopefully can have a good position at Google with it. We also do this at the German page. And if you are searching like Haflinger for sale or to buy, for example, in Germany, you always find your horses in the first positions, which is really, really great. And we want to have this in the other countries as well, of course. And on the other hand, we also want to have informative content, because we think it's good for the user if they get to know more about the horse breed they want to buy, because it's a really big step to buy a horse, and you, when you have more information, it's always better for you. So as we just told you, we have five different languages: English, Dutch, French, Spanish, Polish, and more are hopefully yet to come in some years, not sure when it will be exactly. And we want to build organic reach with SEO optimized text. And in the German website, we have about 250 texts for each horse breed, roundabout. And that are a lot of texts, as you can imagine. And we are not able to speak all of these languages, and that's why we got in contact with TextBroker, and they are writing these really, really great texts for us, so our site can grow and grow, and is getting bigger and bigger. So, of course, it's important that you organize all of this, and especially when you have like this huge number of texts, it's always good if you have a good strategy. And now we want to present ours to you. First of all, we made a huge sheet with all of the different horse breeds for every nation, for every language, because you know every language has, or every nation has another search volume for each horse breed. So we looked up everything and built this sheet. So we get to know, okay, in the Netherlands, we have to translate this at first. This is the most important, but in France, for example, we have to translate another horse breed first because that is more important. Yeah, and then we started this huge project and decided, as you can see here, to build one top, one center, and one bottom text. I will explain you later on why we choose like this. So now we show you the content displayed in our front end, so you get to know how it looks like. So this is our top text, which has a transactional focus. So it's a little bit of how to sell or how to buy the horse, like some random information about this, and yeah. Hopefully all of the users get to know how to buy or how to sell with e-horses and why to buy the horse, for example. Then we have one center text, which is next to our advertisements. And it has a informational character with, for example, the characteristic of the different horses. And we have one bottom text, which is about, for example, the history of the horse. So it's informational as well. Just to explain why we choose it like this, because I think all of you know these landing pages, which are full of the different ads. And after this, you have like one really, really big text. It's always called the SEO text. And you find, of course, a lot of information in this text, but it's not that user friendly because the user see this text at the end of the site, and there are not that many users who are scrolling to this part of the site. And we think it's more user friendly if you split the text, because when you create content, it has to be for the user and not for the search engine. So we've split it up into different parts, three different parts, and hopefully the users are having like a good deal with it. So they can read it, they can inform about the different horse breed, and hopefully they think, okay, it's great content, and we don't want to just build content for the search engine, because a site has to be user-friendly, and that is one of our biggest goals.
So that's a little look to our content displayed in our backend. Of course, the texts themselves are the most important part, but it's always important too to show the search engine what country are the texts for, and so on. So what you can see here are the different languages we have on our site, and we just put the text in the different languages within our backend, but we have to use some text to make the search engine understand which country and which language the texts are for. So for example, in Switzerland you don't only speak German, you maybe speak France too, so we have to take very good care for that, because we don't want to have some Google problems like duplicate content, because as if you heard in the beginning, 40% of our website traffic is coming from search engines like Google, and we don't want to lose it. So we use especially those two tags for our content management in the backend. One is the canonical tag. It's always a self-referring tag. For example, on the Haflinger breed, the canonical tag is showing to the Haflinger breed. So when you use filters in our system, the URL changes, but the content doesn't. So we help the search engine to understand which is the original text and the original URL. So that helps a lot with duplicate content problems. And also, we are using hreflang tags for each text. So that's how it looks for our homepage, actually. And you can see here the different countries and the different languages. So the third search engine can see, okay, the Haflinger is not only a horse we are selling in Germany, but also maybe in France, also Netherlands. So we help the search engine to understand the concept behind our user-friendly content.
Okay, and now I want to talk about the success we have so far. So maybe just to get to know our timeline, we started working with TextBroker in September last year, where we said, okay, it would be great if you like build three or four texts for every language, for every horse breed, one in a month. So we just started very small, but as we just told you some minutes before, of getting international is like the main project of eHorses for 2020. We said in January, okay, we want to put more power in this content management. And TextBroker started to build or to create about 30 texts for every language every month. So there were a lot of new content we put at our website monthly since January. And normally you say, like, when you put new content on a site, it took like 3 or 2 months in a row, that when you like have an impact and when you see a strongly development. And yeah, here you can see our development of the organic traffic. Most of the texts we put in January, and since March our organic traffic is growing, which is a really, really great sign for us. So we get to know that these texts are good, the quality is good, and our management seemed to be good, so we are really happy with this development. Here you can see it for eHorses.com and eHorses.nl. They are growing and growing, and the other countries as well. So eHorses in Spain, France, and Poland is growing and growing. That's really, really good for us. The organic traffic is getting higher and higher, and right now we are quite excited how it will look like at the end of the year, because when we are doing a tempo like this, yeah, we are not sure where we are, but we are really happy with it. So we will go on with creating texts, improving our website. So it's getting more user-friendly, and hopefully more people get in contact with eHorses from abroad. So here we want to show you our top landing pages from France within the organic traffic. And here you can see the top 10 landing pages, and 8 out of the landing pages are about a horse breed. So that is again a great sign that these landing pages are found by the users and they are using it. So yeah, it's a good sign for us that we have to do this going on, and yeah, we will hopefully improving the site more and more. Another sign for us that eHorses is growing is the fact that eHorses as a keyword is more searched. Here it is in Poland, for example, from May 2019 till April 2020. And as you can see, in May last year, it was searched a little bit as well. So the people got to know eHorses a little bit, but not that much. And right now, more people are searching eHorses, so that's a good sign that the people get in contact with the brand and remember the name of the brand. And of course, we know that it's not only because of the organic search, because we also are strong in social media, or we are at some events where we present eHorses, but we think the organic search and these really good landing pages we created so far are, yeah, a good sign for it as well. So more people get in contact with eHorses, and hopefully more people are searching eHorses with a search engine. And the same we can say for Spain. And especially for this, we have like a little goal for ourselves, because this is the current situation in Germany. So there you can see that e-horses as a keyword is more searched than the word Pferde, which means horses in German. And hopefully this is how it looks like in every country in about some years, that e-horses is more searched than horses. So hopefully we can manage that.
So our content management is a process. There's no way we would stop this process. And of course, we have a lot of next steps planned. We are not quite there yet. And the first one is to improve our content management even further. So we are planning to put more interlinks and pictures on our text like this one, and also improving the quality of the content ongoing. So that we don't like to put a text on a website and leave it there for years and never touch it. That's not what we like, because our customers have a lot of requests and ideas, and every country is different and we are still learning. So we are always improving the quality and the content of our texts, actually. That's a big step we are taking, and for each country it's a little bit different. Also, a big deal in our content management are the magazines. So for our German website, we already have a big magazine, the eHorses magazine, which is performing very, very good, actually. And the Netherlands also have a magazine which is not that big yet, because we don't put have much time to put effort in it, but now this will change. It's a big focus for us. So all the countries you've just seen, like .com or Poland and so on, are going to have their own magazines. So we don't have to focus just on the breeds or the disciplines, because there's so much more in the horse sector, like horse knowledge all about horses, tournaments and so on, horse products. It's a huge market, actually, and every country has its own special interests, and we want to get to our customers. We want to help our customers even after the purchase of a horse. So that's why we came up with the magazines, which will be published very soon, especially the .com version of our magazine. And that's not where we're going to stop. Also, as you have just seen, we are a part. We're taking part of geo-targeting, so we have a .com version, a .nl version, .fr version, but that's not enough, because we think that the citizens, for example, in America and Great Britain are very different, and they are very different when it comes to horses as well. So in America, Western riding is a huge deal, while in Great Britain, the people are more into dressage riding, which are both disciplines for equestrians. And there are a lot more differences even in the wording. So American English and British English are using a lot of different words. So we want to focus on that even more too. So there will be an ehorses.co.uk version maybe as well soon, so we can go more to our target groups to help them even better than just having a mass product for everyone. That wouldn't work for our system. And above all, our main goal is to respect the rules, the Google guidelines especially, because we have so much traffic from Google or Bing, or for example, we don't want to lose this. So we are trying to make everything on a white hat SEO way, for a good way. We don't want to cheat with our system. We create content and for our users, and UX is a very important part too. So whatever we do, we make sure that we are maintaining the Google guidelines, so we don't lose this big part of our traffic, and that's still working. So our goal above all is to be the biggest horse market in the world by 2025, and I think it's very possible that we can achieve this goal, so hopefully we will.
Okay, now we come to the end of the presentation. So thank you so much for listening to us. And if you have any question, just ask now.
Great. Thank you very much, Sarah and Michelle. Actually, what you haven't said, which I would like to say, though, is you're also engaged in online marketing. For those German visitors here in this presentation, there will be an online marketing conference, hopefully, next year at, yes, at the eHorses headquarters. It didn't work out this year because of Corona, but I think that's a very interesting thing as well, that you not only engage in your own site, but also into online marketing. That's correct, right? It's up next year?
Yeah, hopefully. Hopefully, yeah. In April next year, yeah.
Yeah, no, so I found that a very interesting idea, and certainly if we're allowed to, we're more than happy to come over next year for your conference.
Yeah, definitely.
You're welcome. You're always welcome.
Great. Okay. Let's see what we can do in terms of questions. One second. Here we go. No, I shared the wrong screen. So I'm going to ask the first question, then figure out technology here. I think you've pretty much answered it, but let me ask it again. What's the advantage of creating new portals for every language instead of creating one single portal which can be expanded to various languages?
The difference is, so the concept of most websites is that search engine optimization is only about getting everything done for the search engine. But we refer to our very own concept, which is more like search experience optimization, so SXO. And that means that you can't just duplicate everything, like the content, the images, the whole style of the website, because every country wants some different peaks here and there, which are not the same, actually, especially when it comes to fully different markets like Asia one time, who knows. So we have to have a single website for each country because we want to get close, as close to our customers as possible.
And I mean, we have these country partners especially for that case, because then we can get to know the market even more. And while we are doing this, we are noticing that every market is a little bit different, and it's really great to have our country partners so we can even have this information. And it was a good choice to like go in different countries with our country partners, so we are hopefully getting better and better with it.
Great. And I think the first results you showed are totally encouraging.
Yeah. Happy about it.
Yeah. The next question I have here for you is, why these languages and countries specifically? Are any other countries interesting for the internationalization of eHorses?
Yes, there are a lot of countries in our interest. We started with the Netherlands or the UK because the countries are very similar to Germany, so our country, so we can learn a lot from our own country. Now that we are growing, we want to expand to little bit different markets as well. For example, Russia is a big interest for us because it's not too much differences to Poland, but a huge horse country as well. Maybe the Arabian states as well are coming soon. We are not sure about that, but we started with Germany because it was with the markets, because we are close to Germany from the search intent and the market intent.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess horses are all over the world, and horse enthusiasts as well. Yeah, it just have to be enough so that it was worthwhile for you, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Next question. Is the massive text content you are providing on your website the main reason for your high organic rankings, or can you see other reasons why you have such high organic rankings?
Of course, this is a really, really big point of our high organic rankings, because that is the main point we are doing so far, like producing new content, improving this content, and these are, as I just showed you, the best performing landing pages we have. Of course, our homepage is really good, has a really good performance as well, but so far I would say the landing pages about the horse breeds are the landing pages which are the best performing ones.
But of course, we're taking care of a lot of other aspects as well. For example, technical SEO, that's a big part of our success story. So we are going on to performing better page speed and so on. And we're also taking big risks in link building. So reaching out a lot of bloggers and magazines which are not our magazines, to get articles from them or share their articles on our site. So it's more like a network, you would say. that's all part of the success.
Yeah, and we also try to put a focus on influencer marketing and do a small combination like of link building and influencer marketing. So if you get a YouTube feature somewhere, we also want to have like this link on YouTube. So I think it would be a really great thing as well. And it's a really great impact to our rankings.
Cool. And I think you've just answered the next question, which I have here. Which you focus, if you also focus on link building, so you said that's what you said. And then someone's asking social media, if to what extent is social media a pillar of your strategy in all of those countries?
Okay, our German website has a really good social media presence. So we have a lot of post ads there or articles out of our magazine, which we are posting on Facebook or Instagram or even on Pinterest. We have to say we are really strong there because there's like a high reach for us because many people are interested in horse content. And for the project of getting international, we also created a Facebook page for even these international pages in English, so we can also reach our international users there. And some month ago we also created a new Instagram account for even our international users, so they get in contact with e-horses hopefully everywhere.
Yeah, with cool. The German Insta account we just reached the 100k followers, which was a very big deal for us.
Great, that's good. Question from myself, as being totally unknowledgeable about horses, is how much competition is there for you guys? Is there any at all?
No, of course, yes. It's very different. Each market is different. In Germany, we are the big player, you could say. So e-horses is the thing to go when buying horses. In different countries, it's not the same. So in the American and British sector, there are a lot of different horse markets, but what they don't offer, but we have, they are just local. So we are international. We offer horses all over the world. So you can search for horses which are located in Spain, in Germany, and so on. And the most other countries don't offer this yet. So that's our chance.
Yeah, many countries have marketplaces, but they are not focused on horses. So that's why I think we are that successful, because they have like a general market with one category of horses, but they do not have like just a horse market or not big horse market online. For example.
Yeah, this is a really cool story. I like it. So to everybody, any more questions, then please type them quickly into the chat. Now this is really cool because you made a niche really, really big for you and occupied it in a way that's really hard to copy. So there's a question on internationalization. I think you answered that, right? So you have different country portals now, thinking about more Russia, Asia, etc.
Yeah.
So I'm a lot of comments here, which are like, I'm impressed. Thank you. Very interesting. So well done. Thank you so much, Sarah and Michelle. And don't leave just yet, everybody. There's money and prizes to win. So for those of you who have been here before, we're going to do a poll in a second. And you can win these prizes. So 100 euro Amazon voucher plus the content consulting from TextBroker and 150 euro to spend with TextBroker on content. Second prize will be 50 euros Amazon and another 150 for TextBroker. And the third prize can still spend 150 euros on TextBroker. And Sarah and Michelle will confirm that for 150 euros, get decent content from us. So in order to win those prizes, please take out your mobile phones and scan this QR code or type in that Slido link, which is below the QR code. And the first question you will see is, did the presentation deliver valuable information? So please, I'll shut up for a few seconds so that you can fill that in, and then we'll move to the second question. So it's quite interesting. We have our vote master here who's sending me messages how much longer I should keep the vote open. So we give it another 10 seconds. This is a fairly easy question. So it's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And you're going to see the next question. And that is, what was your main takeaway from the presentation? And this is a freeform answer. Therefore, you're going to look at a little more time. And it's obviously the most important question for Sarah, Michelle, and also ourselves to see, you know, what have you taken away from this presentation? What can we maybe learn to make the next Digital Marketing League even better? So please take some time to give us your feedback, which is very important for us. So we're going to leave that one open a little longer so that you can write some, maybe some longer comments. So looking at my voting master again, he writes a bit more time needed. So you'll get a bit more time. Please feel free to answer. What's the main takeaway from the eHorses presentation? All right, we'll give it another 10 seconds. This is like the launch of a space shuttle. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And the last question is actually not a question, but if you want to win one of the prizes, please enter your email address. And those of you who have participated in polls before, every time you put your email address in, it gets you one more chance to win one of the prizes. And Sarah and Michelle still getting very positive comments here. Fantastic insights, very interesting. So one of the best presentations, there you go. Okay, I think that's pretty much it. Actually, to get to the next session, I know we had some difficulties with some of the participants. So if you go back to this page and then you pick the right slot, which is actually the 3 p.m. slot starting in 19 minutes, select that one, and then you get a confirmation like this, which gets you into the next session, which, as I said, starts in 19 minutes at 3 p.m. And that will be with Trustpilot, moderated by my colleague Zora, who you've probably met in the morning. And then we move on with the Digital Marketing League. So thanks, everybody. Thank you, Sarah and Michelle. Great presentation. And I'll see you in 19 minutes. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Ciao. Bye-bye.